going on? It's TJ Broskoff from Southern Satellite. We're here at SG Studios in Fort Worth, Texas with Greg White. He produced the last record, and in this little series I'm calling Behind the Mix, I wanted to do something a little bit different for everybody. And instead of just talk about what the song was for the new project that I put out, I wanted to really get into the nuts and bolts of what we did to create the sound that we got with this record. And today's episode is going to be about Needle to the Bone, which is the first song off of the new record. And let's just dive in, let them hear a little bit of what's going on with it. Acoustic doing this really cool riff, this kind of double time Irish jig feel, but we wanted to embellish that a little bit, and I picked up a bouzouki, which is a Russian instrument. It may have came from Italy, I'm not sure. I believe it's Russian though. It's essentially an 8-string long weird mandolin kind of thing, and we put some texture over the guitar with that. That's right there.
All the way through the track, he played these kind of long notes on the bouzouki, and it just kind of sat there. It was cool in the mix, but then I wanted to make something a little bit more interesting with it when we mixed, and so I just grabbed a wah pedal.
Isolate that for this. It's kind of, it almost, it reminds me of that Australian instrument. What is that?
A didgeridoo.
Didgeridoo.
A little bit, yeah. It's that kind of vibe. Just adds another texture.
Right. And then we had Milo Deering in on this session. And he, besides rewriting the chart 3 times, because we're not even sure exactly what key this song is in.
It's a weird one.
I just kind of write things. And he did this really cool Mando thing where he's pretty much comping what I'm doing.
So then Milo by himself. Nice little fill there.
Yeah, I love that little part.
He's brilliant.
This song is about drug addiction. It's about a friend that tragically died from an overdose. And we were trying to really capture that whole darkness emotion, and I think we did a really good job with it.
Yeah, when we were in pre-production, I really, going over the lyrics to all the songs on the record, this song moved me. There's a certain section where he talks about he doesn't want to commit suicide because he thinks he'll go to hell, and that like blew me away emotionally. And so once we got to that part of the song, I really felt like we had to really capture the feeling of that and the emotion of that.
Let's go into the chorus. We did something with back vocals. You did like a reverse or something? I can't remember exactly.
Yeah, so...
I just want to put that gun to my head. Turn on the lights and go to bed. And we just stacked these vocals. They're not way out in front, they're just back there,
yeah,
kind of.
Very back. They make a little bit of somewhat of a creepy vibe in there, you know, especially that reverse part. So I had him sing,
yeah.
And then I reversed
and
it.
Then we reversed
now he
goes,
it.
I just want to put that gun to my head. Turn on the lights and go to bed.
Yeah,
ago. So the vamp, we kind of, I think the idea was we bring it all back down and we try and get intimate with the character of the song.
Yeah, it's a tension and release, just to really try and bring the emotion out of what the story's about.
Right. You know? Yeah, I'm going crazy. I'm going crazy. I'm going crazy. And I think Greg's thought with this was it's all the voices that were going on in his head.
I really wanted it to be inside the person's head. He's going crazy. He says right there at that point, I'm going crazy, I'm going crazy. And so all these voices and things that talk to you.
Here we go. I don't really know what Mr. Rock's supposed to be talking about.
So just put this murmuring in here. You know. Is it a psychotic feel? So yeah, together. Yeah, I'm going crazy. I'm going crazy. I remember during the record, I wanted that to be real big.
Yeah.
And you were like, no, it has to stay low. And I didn't quite capture what you were going for until we got it down.
So right there, we had an amp here in the studio. A very nice amp, by the way. And Greg says, drop it.
Custom-built Dustin Beasley Princeton.
They're spring reverb in amps, right? And so what you do is it vibrates in there, and that's what creates the verb. And so what we did is we turned the reverb on the amp all the way up, and then we dropped it so that the spring actually slapped inside of the head. And
yeah, it became a subtle gunshot.
Yeah.
You know, it really brings that gunshot vibe of the bullet to the bone. And then with a lot of reverb on it.
Yeah, that was our simulated gunshot. We get to the very last part, and it's balls to the wall, and everything is in. Make my
stand. Yeah, keeping this last chorus down was really important. The damned. Lyric. Single tear and the hammer slams. Last part there, it's just like a cry out, you know. That I love that piece.
I do too. It
gives me cold chills.
So there you have it. That's Needle to the Bone. We're going to go ahead and play the whole song for you so you can hear it and you can kind of listen for little things that we pointed out that we did to it. I hope you enjoy it. I'm on my own, broken down without a home. Swollen vein and a drug takes hold, needle to the bone. I've lost track somewhere of me. Hate this person I've come to be. My final moment, my final plea, needle to the bone.
gone crazy. Dark room, I'll make my stand. I've given up, I've become the damned. Single tear and the hammer slams. Bullet to the bone. Bullet to the bone.
Hope y'all enjoyed that. We're going to do a whole series about each song that we did on this project. So come check back. We'll try and notify you when we do another one. Until then, hope everybody stays safe, and we will see you soon.